Yes, and our God never changes. He's the same yesterday, today, and forevermore. And Lynn was telling us about sharing and caring. But you know, no one can ever teach you how to give. You cannot be taught how to be charitable. But once you're in love, you give freely. Once you love with God's creation, you give freely. And today we're talking about giving. What can you give? It doesn't have to be money. You cannot give money alone. You can also give with service, with time, your resources. Once you fall in love with God's creation, you can give freely. And as Christian, we are supposed to be charitable. Yeah? Not to use, as in we don't give to be seen as good people, to be labeled. Because you've seen cases, pale social media, once people give, there's a picture, wamepiga, wamepost pale. You know, today I was in this children's home. No, we don't give so that we can be seen with the media people or even our friends, or so that tukaenda tukatangaze kule nje at, you know, I've been giving, or we can be labeled as good people. We give because we are giving it to Christ. Anything we give or anything we do it for Christ. Once you're in love with Christ, you give freely. And every time you give, picture yourself like you're helping Christ. Because everything you, because by serving and giving others, you are giving it to Christ. So our inspiration vibe comes from the book of Matthew chapter 25, tukianza na verse 34. I think at this rate, itabidi nimeleta ile table ya inakuanga kama church. Comes from the book of Matthew chapter 25, tukianza na verse 34, which says, then the king will say to those on his right, come, you who are blessed by my Father, take your inheritance, the kingdom prepared for you since the creation of the world. For I was hungry, and you gave me something to eat. I was thirsty, and you gave me something to drink. I was a stranger, and you invited me in. I needed clothes, and you clothed me. I was sick, and you looked after me. I was in prison, and you came to visit me. 37. Then the righteous will answer him, Lord, when did we see you hungry and feed you, or thirsty and give you something to drink? When did we see you a stranger and invite you in, or needing clothes and clothe you? When did we see you sick or in prison and go to visit you? The king will reply, I tell you the truth. Whatever you did for the one or the least of these brothers of mine, you did it for me. You know, these people were expecting Christ to be clothed in tattered clothes. They were expecting him to be hungry, akaitu hapo na akonja, so that they can actually give back. They can give him food, they can give him time, they can visit him in prison. But the king is telling him, whatever you did for the least of these brothers of mine, you did it for me. How much is it? What more do you need? Actually, this verse is just like self-explanatory. Whatever you did for the least of, ule mse umekatu na ekando, unamona hana nguo, unexpect Christ akuja bila nguo ndo umpe, but you cannot give the person who is next to you. Begin with the person next to you. Your brother at home, the people you see in that plot, ule mse unaona mtaani, hajiwezi. Begin with that. Si lazima ikuwe do. It's not a must to be money. You can give that person your clothes, your time. You can visit the sick. You can visit your brother who is in prison, because kuna wasee wameshikwa kule jela, kuna wengine, because I've done ministries in, I've gone missions to prison, that those who have not been visited ever since they were put there, never been visited. Kama una ule mse wako ako kule ndani, begin with that person. Enda ukamwone kesho ama hata leo. Don't postpone it. Begin now. Go visit those who are sick. Don't expect Christ to be sick, no visit. Because once you do it for the least of my brothers, you are doing it for Christ. So let us love, let us give, let us fall in love with God's creation. Because once you fall in love with God's creation, you will give freely. So the main point is here, the key commandment, which is love, fall in love, and you will give freely. Mm. Yes, and we can also give back to the society using our gifts. Eh? Kama ukona gift ya kuimba also, tunaweza anza pale church by singing. We've seen Lucky Franklin here. Alikuwa anatuambia na serve PCA kule. Anaimba in praise and worship. You can do that. Si lazima utoe hit song first and useme, eh, mazemi nimeserve. No, you can begin by singing back at your church home. And I like what Ruben Kigame told us one day. Unajua wasanii wanamdai, oh, when Kigame, you know, we want a hit song. No, no, you can begin at your home church. Imba, God sees. God see your service and rewards that. Also with your talents, singing, dancing, making clothes. Kuna wale wase wakopoa kumeka nguo. Si lazima ta. Or you can give out your clothes. Kama wakopoa kushona nguo. Shona ule mseana nguo. Uko, unajua tunakujanga Nairobi, tunasahau penye tumetoka. Remember your people in the village. Wapeleke, serve them, give them. Don't hold those things that God has given you. Open your hands, give them out. Because whatever you do, you're doing it for Christ. Also, I like what 1 Peter says. Let me just get that book. 1 Peter 4 verse 10, 11 says, each one should use whatever gift he has received to serve others. Faithfully administering God's grace in its various form. If anyone speaks, he should do it as if anyone speaks, he should do it as one speaking the very words of God. If anyone serves, he should do it with the strength God provides. So, don't hold back what gifts and talents and your money and your resources let us give. Not that we can be labeled, let's do it because you are doing it for Christ. I will leave you with a quote by Billy Graham, which says, God has given us two hands. One to receive and the other to give. To squat what we kupokea, we can also give. We don't have to be rich. We can give whatever we have. The little we have, tuanzie tu hapo. Let us give back and let us love God's creation. That is our inspiration vibe for today. Catch more of this next Sunday. Yes.
Wow. And you see. That's awesome. Mm-hmm. And it's such a blessing one. Umeongeleleo kitu nikakumbuka like, blessed is the hand that gives. Mm-hmm. Where is the outer white cause?